Ohio is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Got it. And he goes down quickly.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. And he's tackled at the 31-yard line.
Nice play, baby. Nice play.
Gain of two on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
Roger, Roger. Mike 38.
Let's go, defense. Hey, man up. Let's go.
That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Ohio's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes, and when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Makes it to the 44.
Check three.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. They'll get a first down there on the play with the run from the tailback.
Good running and a strong push to get into the second level of that defense.
Here we go.
Tackled right around midfield.
That makes it second and 10.
They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line.
I thought there was a chance he'd be brought down before getting to the marker. It was a great effort there to get beyond for the first down.
He's at the 30. He makes his way to about the 28.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. First down.
From the 28-yard line. First down.
Check Mike 40.
Let's go.
Red
68.
And he hits him hard at the 29. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
I'm sure this running back will be looking around for that guy the next time he takes a handoff.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Fires it out. Tackle made at the 15.
Number three, at the 15-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Check three.
And he is drilled at the 14-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
That's good for the 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Mike 40, check. He's coming. He's ready. Check three.
Touchdown, OU. He makes the PAT. And 11-play, 64-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Bobcats are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's taken down at the 23.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 23-yard line.
Black five, black five. Blue 20. Easy, easy.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That brings up third and 10.
Red two.
Kill, kill, kill.
Gunner three.
Motion, motion, motion. Reset.
He wants it all going long. Intercepted. It's the junior corner. And he's level at the 41. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. Ohio is up a score. Makes the catch, and look out. He steps out right around the 42-yard line. And they make the stop at about the 45. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Gets it out quickly. Got an opening. And he's taken down at the 41-yard line.
Number seven makes the tackle at the 41-yard line. First down.
Gets out to around the 32.
That's good for the game. That makes it second and two.
Here he goes. He's at the 20. And he tackles him hard at the 17-yard line.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
Mike 40, Mike 40.
Has some daylight. The five.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
Looking to go up two touchdowns. Let's see if they try to pound it in here. Both teams have their goal line sets on the field. Fumble. It's scooped up. And this could be a big return. Touchdown, Penn State.
Great play here by the defender. You know, it's trickier than it looks to scoop up a loose ball and then get your motor started. He was able to do it and made that play look smooth for the touchdown.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This offense has got to try to pull it all together now after the fumble cost them 6 points just moments ago.
Well, this is what we're really going to find out, how this team can rebound and what kind of leadership that they have. You know, the last time they were out there, they turned the ball.
And it's intercepted. And who else? It's the senior safety. Broke away from one. And down he goes around the 46-yard line.
This safety always seems to be in the right place at the right time. It's no surprise that he comes up with the interception here.
From the 46-yard line, first down. And he's tackled right away. So at the end of one quarter, we get a tie game at 7-7. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Down at the 35, and they keep it on the ground for the first down.
Nothing too fancy here. The key is that the running back was able to convert the first down.
From the 35-yard line, first down. Nice catch, first down. He's knocked out. Six. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Red two.
Throws it, and he's got the tight end again. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Touchdown, Nittany Lions.
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Got some open field. And they get nice yardage on that run. They'll drop it for a loss. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere.
With the defensive line neutralizing the blocks, these linebackers are able to come up and make plays in the holes.
Throws it in a hurry. Tries to get around the corner. That's a great tackle at the 45-yard line.
That brings us second and 9.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
So we're looking at another third down here. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch.
That'll make it 4th and 10.
punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Penn State is up 7. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He passes it. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Makes it out to about the 23. It's first and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Caught out of the open.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
Up the middle for a nice run. The Nittany Lions use their second timeout. Penn State is up by a touchdown. He's got it out to his tight end, and he's tackled just outside the goal line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Zone touchdown.
That'll be a big boost. You always want to capitalize on these short yardage situations, and that pass was an excellent call.
And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 66-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So the score now, 21-7. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 25. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. They get a 1-yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From their own 24-yard line, it's 3rd down. Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. That's not going to move the sticks.
This defense played some sound football out there and did a good job of not letting them get into any kind of rhythm.
And watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here. And this one is a beauty. Room around the corner. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line, and that'll do it for the first half. 24-7, Nittany Lions.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. When you don't give up any sacks and neither team did in the first half, the offensive line gets a lot of credit and deservedly so. Quarterbacks also deserve some credit for that. They get rid of the football on time, Throw it away when they need to, but a lot of times they're doing it because they don't really feel any heat from the defense.
Yeah, and defensively, you got to be able to see that. And if it's a three-step drop, then all you can do is get your hands up, try to deflect footballs. And if you're in the middle and you're a defensive tackle, try to push that guard as much as you can. So when that quarterback steps up, he has to step into somebody. Or how about you make a move and get outside of the pocket? You know, especially the blind side. The blind side of the quarterback, we always talk about that guy, you know, in the NFL making all the money. A lot of times you can take more risk. You can come inside on a pass rush or come outside because the quarterback can't see you. So some way, shape, or form, they got to start making sure that they make him uncomfortable and get some pressure on him.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Just going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. The Nittany Lions continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 25.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
From their own 25-yard line, third down.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit for the quarterback. We'll be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He showed a good burst there. They're set to go for another round.
Man left, man left.
Four down.
Mark 38.
Set. Down.
Blue 42.
Watch the slant.
He's out of bounds at the 45. They gained 5 yards there.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
From the 45-yard line, it's second down.
Green nine, green nine.
He scrambled. He's tackled in the open field. Gains his way to the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's first down. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. And they make the stop at the 8. Scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He makes the PAT. So that's a 5-play, 50-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
Excellent kick. Penn State gets set to kick this one away. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Ohio's getting stomped right now. They're unable to get anything going here in the third quarter.
Well, I think what they have to do at this point is they've got to get into a little bit more of a hurry-up mode, a little bit more urgency, score, and hope that the defense can come up with a stop and hope you can get the ball back and put more points on.
Immediately tackled.
First down.
Roger, Roger. Yeah, check. Hey, Mike. Hey, no, let's switch the mic right here.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Five wide. Throws incomplete. It's third and 10. Ball on their own 37. Knocked down. Incomplete.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Booming kick. He takes it in at the 14. Pretty good job by the return man there. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time. You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage the team's confidence if it keeps happening.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. And he is drilled at the 34.
Green 9, green 9, green 8.
tackle at the 39. A 5-yard gain.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
It's second and 5 here. Ball on their own 39.
Red, 2, go!
Quick out to his receiver. Very good tackle in space. Tackle at the 49. From their own 49-yard line. It's second down.
That makes it second and 6.
Red, 2, 3, 8.
Watch the motion.
And he's taken down around the 43-yard line. For the corner, brought down right around the 44-yard line. Loss of 1 on the toss play.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 44-yard line, second down. Quick throw. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33.
Three down.
Mike 38!
Today. Here we go.
Has some daylight. Touchdown, Penn State. Wow, how about that call to the tight end? Big payoff.
Well, the offensive coordinator has wanted to incorporate this young player into their passing attack, and he couldn't have picked a better time to get him the ball.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose.
Down! Blue 14!
Motion!
Cut! Fires it out. He's taken down at about the 31. So at the end of the third quarter, Penn State leads 38-7. This one has been a blowout since the beginning. Hopefully the fourth quarter will turn things around.
40's the mic.
Sam! Red 68! Red 68!
He's under some heat. He heaves it deep. It's going the other way.
You don't want to criticize a quarterback for trying to make something happen, but I'm not really sure who he thought he was throwing the ball to there.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. Penn State. Looking to build on this commanding lead here. And he tackles him hard at the 46. He's at the 40, and he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line.
Here we go.
got the junior. And down he goes at the 20.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
Swings it out left to the halfback. And they hit him in the backfield.
Number 25 takes him down for a loss behind the line at the 20-yard line.
From the 20-yard line. Second down. Good open field tackle. Comes to the line. They got a big advantage in this one.
Red two, blue four, blue four.
Him hard at the 1 yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
It's second and goal. About a yard to Pater. They're crowding the line. In another touchdown, and so they punch it in on the ground. Kirk Herbstreit,
great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown,
and he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Bobcats thought they had the right game plan and the right player to do it. Neither worked out for them.
Yeah, I think the game plan and the star player came into this game with a lot of confidence. What they weren't able to really think about was how good this defense would be that they were facing today. And today, they just got completely shut down.
Steps out of bounds at the 28.
Second seven.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Just under two to go in the game. Got an opening, and he's tackled in the open field.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. First down.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Made at the
38.
He airs it out. And it's intercepted. And who else? It's the senior safety.
Brad, I'm all for continuing to fight and continuing to try to compete. But another interception, another miscue for this team, They're already getting blown out. They've got no chance to get back in the game.
From their own 24-yard line. First down. Got an opening. Brought down in the open field.
That's good for 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line.
No gain on the play.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Ohio's staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.